Then dip me underway. You can kill me on my first love and I went slow. Hold me till I scream for air to breathe. And wash me over until my will runs dry. Send all your sins all over me, baby. Me, baby, me.
What's up, A-Gang? I am back at it again with another freaking video. Just ignore my background, it is a freaking mess. I'm about to try to pull everything together now, but this video is a little different. It's not a regular weekly vlog. It's a vlog, but it's not a weekly vlog. So this is a vlog of me getting ready to leave the country without my family. You heard it right. I am going on vacation without my husband and without my kids. It's a girls trip and it's for my friend, my long time friend, one of my besties. It's for her 40th birthday. This trip has been planned for quite some time now, but it's finally here. We have 2 days left, y'all, until I leave. Mind y'all, I never travel without my family. I have traveled without my family one time, and that was to go to Atlanta for a TikTok event. And if you watched that video, you know that I went and turned around and came right back home the same day. So I've never really traveled without my family. Only traveled once without the fun police, and that was just this past month when me and Lexi went to Houston so that she can train. Other than that, never traveled without the fun police. So this is gonna be interesting. Plus, I'm gonna be around a whole bunch of people that I don't know. Only people that I know is my friend and her sisters, but it's 13 of us total. So that means 10 people I don't know. If y'all know anything about me, y'all know that I am not a people person. But I'm gonna make it work. Now it's time to do some maintenance. Y'all, I'm steady stopping and looking. Ah, get out of there. Cairo is drinking out of the toilet. No, we don't do that here, sir. Y'all, he looking at me like, and how come? So anyway, I'm doing some maintenance, some personal maintenance, so I can be ready for this trip. As y'all can see, your girl need her hair done, but I do not have a loctician. I maintain my locks myself, mainly because I don't do any of the fancy styles or anything like that. I don't like my hair being pulled. Like, if you see me with a ponytail, you know that a couple of hours later, that ponytail was taken out. So I can do like styles where they're gonna be up for days, maybe weeks at a time. I don't like that. It makes me uncomfortable. So I just rather retwist my own hair and keep pushing. So I ordered some new product because I didn't like the product that I was using, that I have been using for a while. I ordered something new and it ain't came in the mail yet. So hopefully it comes in the mail today. That way I can do my retwist today and get that done and out the way. I have a wax appointment at 6:30. Y'all, I have not waxed in years, okay? I've been trying to maintain it down there myself, but you know, when you going on vacation and you about to be in swimsuits and stuff, you want to make sure it's right. So I'm gonna go get waxed today. I'm a little nervous about that because I know it's gonna hurt since I ain't been in a while, but we're gonna get there. We're gonna cross that bridge when it comes. I also need to get my toes done, and then I need to make a few runs to grab some last minute items for the trip, and then we're gonna pack. Today is Monday, I leave on Wednesday, so I'm trying to be packed today. That way on Wednesday, it's a smooth transition. I'm not feeling rushed, I'm not feeling, you know, overwhelmed or anything. And then also, I have to clean my house before I leave. I can't go on vacation without cleaning my house. And we're just gonna pray that it look the same when I get back, since I'm the only one leaving. My whole family's still gonna be here. And my whole family is the ones that be having the house looking crazy. But we not gonna even talk about it. So anyway, that is what this vlog is about. So if you're interested to see me get ready for my first solo trip, well, it's a solo trip, but it ain't a solo trip. Stay tuned because that's what we're about to do.
This is too small.
Hey, this is the only, y'all, this is too small. I didn't know they ran small, but it's the only thing that I have to match with the bottoms. So anyway, first stop, we going to get nails done. I don't know why she's here.
Huh? She's like, no appointment. I'm like, that's not what I'm
getting. Oh. Why are you here? I am going on vacation.
But I'm going to school. I guess she's getting herself ready for school. She's going back to school next week. What did you just say?
No, you know, people have foot fetishes, and that's very weird to me.
You need to put some moisturizer on.
Yeah, I know. Yeah.
She look, they looking at the book like, we ain't no, they changed it in here. Hello. Two pedicures. Yeah. No. It looks nice in here.
Gel.
Yeah. When they change it up? Really? Yeah, it's nice in here now. I'm just getting white. About the white toes, that's just, I don't know, it does something for me. Yeah, Leah tried something new. What's that, a Kit Kat? They did turn out to look nice. Her, the lady who did yours, her, she had French tips and hers looked nice. So
Her toe?
Mm-hmm. So I know she was about to clown on yours. She kind of went kind of quick. I liked him. I actually like him. I might start coming to him.
She really? Was going fast. She
was
hurt my foot
because
she was trying to get this.
Yeah, she was rushing. You going back to the house, ain't you?
Mm-hmm.
I'm finna give you something to give daddy. All
right.
If I can freaking find it. Hold on, y'all. I'll be right back. All right, so since we got that out the way, we can move on to the next thing. There is a Target that's right here, and there's actually a pair of pants. Well, they're not pants. They're like cover-up pants that I wanted to get. I passed them up the last time, so I don't know if this Target has it. I was at a different Target. I passed them up because they were just all black sheer. Yeah, I was like, I don't know, they're not spicy enough for me. But when I got back home and I started going through like my swimsuits that I purchased, I have, damn, they got this bush right here. You can't even see what's on the other side. I have this swimsuit and I did a TikTok video on it some time back. But I have an all black, it's a two-piece swimsuit and it has like a sheer crop top that goes with it. And I think the sheer crop top will match the sheer pants in Target. And it'll be a cute little, you know, cover-up outfit. So I'm gonna run to Target, grab that, and then see what else they have in here. I really don't need nothing else. I think I have everything. I'm only gonna be gone for 4 days. So I think I have everything I absolutely need. But you know, if I see something that I can add to the collection, the vacation collection, I'm gonna get it. Because why not? You only live once. So let's run into this Target right quick, grab the pants, look around just for a hot second, and then we all to our next stop. The pants that I'm looking for, but I can't fit no damn extra small, so that's gonna be a no. It looks like all they have is extra smalls in that. Is this a medium? Nope, that's an extra small. What the hell? So I'm probably gonna be stuck going to a different Target to find at least a medium, if not a small. I could probably get away with a small. I need a medium, but I can probably squeeze into a small. I don't know. So I'm gonna go ahead and just go to the next location because I don't want to waste too much time because I have too much stuff that I'm trying to
do. Now we are at the mall. I went to a different mall at first and I didn't record because the phone police was on the phone telling me about some crap that's going on with the new construction, but that's a story time for a different vlog. But I end up not getting anything from that mall. I went to Lululemon because I need an airport outfit. So I went to Lululemon. They didn't have what I was looking for. So I'm at a different mall right now to go into a different Lululemon. I'm looking for like a tan color, like a light, maybe an off-white tan, off-white or tan legging with maybe a jacket to match, or maybe like a top like this to match, or maybe this same outfit but just in a tan color. I don't know. I don't even know if that exists because I haven't been at Lululemon in a little second, and I'm feeling kind of weird walking through this mall recording right now. I just feel like everybody be looking at me. No one is probably paying me any mind, but in my head, everybody's looking at me. So I don't have a lot of time. I still gotta go get waxed at 6:30. It is 4:30 right now. I'm a good 45 minutes away from the house. Plus I have to fight traffic. So I don't have a lot of time to waste. So let's go. Almost made you love me, almost made you cry, almost made you happy, babe, didn't I, didn't I? You almost had me thinking, you were turned around, but everybody knows, almost to go. Almost heard you saying, you were finally free, what was always missing for you, babe, you found it in me. But you can't get to heaven, and all the crime. Later. Wong, wong, wong. Y'all, I done been to two different Lululemons and they ain't have shit in neither one. The second one that I went to, they was packed as hell in there, and I forgot it's back to school time. So I forgot everybody is school shopping for their freaking kids. So I did not find anything at the mall today, like literally nothing. So it looks like I'm probably gonna be wearing something out of my closet to the airport. And home, like to and coming back home. I do normally get airport outfits for trips, for big trips. Like if I'm just doing a little turnaround trip, I don't be really tripping like that. I'll be probably at the airport looking crazy as hell. But like when I'm going on vacation, I do get a new airport outfit, but it don't look like I'm gonna get one this time around. But that's okay. I am headed to my wax appointment right now, and I don't know, maybe y'all should tell me. Back years ago when I was getting waxed consistently, I was normally having my appointments in the morning, like first thing in the morning. That way I was taking my shower, getting dressed and going straight to my appointment. I took a shower this morning, but that was earlier. It is 5:36 right now, and I've been ripping and running. Is that bad that I go straight to my appointment? Cause I'm really feeling like I need to go home first, like rush home. My appointment's at 6:30. It's 5:36 right now. I am still about maybe 30 minutes away from my house. I'm like, do I rush home, freshen up first, then go to the appointment? Or do I go like I am? I don't feel like I should go like I am. But what do y'all be doing? Like, for real. What y'all be doing? Help a sister out. I decided to go home and freshen up first. So I went home, freshened up. Now I just got here. It's 6:15. My appointment is about 15 minutes. But I'm going to go in early just in case they can get me in early. Y'all pray for me, because this shit finna hurt. Like bad.
All right, we are done. They would not let me record, y'all. I was gonna bring y'all in there with me, so that y'all can see my reaction to getting waxed, a Brazilian wax, for the first time in like 2 or 3 years. And they was like, oh, it's company policy. And she was like, if it wasn't a policy, I would totally let you do it. So I'm like, dang, whatever. And it wasn't that bad. It wasn't that bad. It was a few strips that hurt, but it wasn't that bad. And then she held a conversation. We talked about everything. Like, I know she probably think I talk too much, but I didn't switch the conversation up talking about kids. I didn't start talking about what else was we talking about in there? Kids. I told her not to have no kids. Damn, I can't even remember everything we talked about. Anywho, we was talking. I feel funny already. Like, I feel, it feels a little sticky back there a little bit. I don't know if she got all the wax off, because it feels like my butt cheeks are waxed together or something. I don't know. I'll figure it out once I get it home. And then she like talked me into buying this ingrown hair serum, and I was like, why not throw it in the bag? So I got that. It is now 7 o'clock. It's 6:58, basically 7 o'clock. And I need to go to Sephora to get some more highlighter, because Cairo decided to destroy my favorite one, so now I have to get a replacement. And then what else did I want to get out of Sephora? It's something else I wanted to get out of Sephora, but I can't think of it right now. So I'm not sure if I'm gonna go to Sephora now or if I'm gonna go tomorrow morning. I'm right here by Sephora, but the fun police needed me to come help him over at the house, so I might just stop what I'm doing so I can help him. But another thing that we doing today is we retwisting these locks. I did get the product in the mail. I got it in the mail before I left the house, so we do have product. We just need to retwist the locks. And y'all, when I tell you, I am dreading this. Like, I am starting to dread retwisting my hair because it has gotten so long and it's just so complicated. And I don't even be doing nothing special. All I'm doing is literally retwisting it. But it gotta get done, so I'm gonna do it tonight, so I ain't gotta be trying to feel like I'm rushing doing it tomorrow. And then just, you know, to give it time, because sometimes when I be using a product, it be a little oily, I kind of feel like. And then I just need some time for my hair to absorb the product before I leave, if that makes sense. That probably didn't make no sense to y'all, but it made sense to me. So anyway, let's move on to the next thing. We're going in Ulta. I was gonna wait until tomorrow, but I'm like, I'm right here, so might as well just go in here just now, get it done out the way. I ain't gonna worry about it no more. So trying to get highlighter. I feel like there's something else that I need. I cannot remember what it is, but I'm just browsing around until I figure it out. What I got from Sephora. When I tell y'all, this shirt is too small, but they don't have this color no more for me to get a bigger size. I didn't realize that they ran so small until after the fact, but just need to hear about it. All right, so I got a Fenty liquid highlighter in, what color is this? Hustler Baby. This seems like it's close to the highlighter that Kylo messed up. I don't know, but it looks like this. And if I put some like on my hand, let me see if I can show y'all kind of what it looked like. And a little goes a long way, because I was trying different colors on in the store and they were like, I was putting too much on my hand basically. Can y'all see that? So that is the highlighter. It's still not like the other one that I had that Cairo messed up, but it would do. So I got that, and then I got some more telescopic lift by L'Oreal. I get the waterproof. So a few of y'all asked me what type of mascara I be using, and this is it. It went viral on TikTok a while ago when like one of the big makeup creators
is my camera falling? When one of the big makeup influencers, not creators, one of the big makeup influencers was accused of using falsies, but was saying that it was this. It was a sponsored video, and she said that she used this, but everybody was like, they can tell that she had falsies on her lashes. So this went viral. So this what made me buy it. But this stuff is really good. Like, super, super, super good. I put at least 2 to 3 coats on each side and comb it through, because it has a comb attached to it. So it's like a comb on one side, then the other side is the, you know, the bristles that you use to put on your lashes. And I just like comb my lashes, then I put the mascara on, comb my lashes again. Like, it's a process, but it works really good. So I got that. What else? Then I got this Anastasia waterproof gel liner. Got that in black, because I have not had any eyeliner in forever. I feel like my lips are dry, y'all. That's why I keep licking my lips and doing this. So yeah. So I got that. If y'all can y'all see that? There we go. Oh, act like you wanted to focus. But yeah, it's just a normal gel eyeliner. I think this was, how much I paid for this? This was actually kind of high in my opinion. I paid for the mascara was $14.99. What? How much did I pay for this? The Fenty stuff, this was $32 freaking, but hopefully it lasts me for some time. And I think this was $18. But so I guess that's not horrible. I guess that wasn't horrible. Then I got a MAC gel eyeliner, pencil eyeliner. Yeah, gel pencil eyeliner by MAC. But I got this in a color white. Well, the color is actually, let's see, it's Incorruptible is what the color is, but basically it's white. I've been wanting to try white on my lash line. I'm trying to let y'all see and it won't focus. Anywho. Yeah, so it's just a gel liner, and it actually comes out really good. Like, it's, you don't have to struggle, like, bam. So I wanted to try white on my lash line. Here come Lexi. No, that's Leah. So I got that. Huh? And then, come smell this. I got Dolce Gabbana.
Dolce Gabbana. Big boofah.
Whatever. I got this just so I could travel with, because I don't have no travel size.
Ooh, Mom, you know what you should buy me? It's this perfume that I've been wanting. No, you know what? I should buy me some Rick Owens. I love that. My nose stopped up.
Is it?
You
can't smell nothing? Yeah, it smells so good. But this is,
how much it costs?
Like $30-some, like $34.
Oh, it's a travel.
Yeah.
You don't have this one already?
No.
That's new. Mm-hmm. Oh, she got a travel size foundation? Oh, no.
No, that's not travel size, but it's a highlighter.
This looks pretty.
Because Cairo broke. Remember the highlighter I brought you a long time ago for homecoming?
And it didn't match me.
Yeah, and I've been using it ever since. Cairo knocked it off the vanity, and then was carrying it around, and I didn't realize that it had busted open until I saw it land on the floor.
What do you need? Why do you need this?
This is when I got my wax.
Oh, it came with it?
No, I had to pay $30-some for this. She got me too. She was like, "Oh, the ingrown hair."
How you know you gonna have some ingrown
hair? I don't know, but I ain't had a heart to tell her no. So I was like, "Okay, you can just add it on there."
No, you already paid.
Huh? No.
I don't care. And when it's my money, I care about stuff like that. If it's y'all, I'm like, get my hair. Add it on there.
Whatever.
It won't hurt.
In the bag.
It won't hurt.
Yeah, I know. I know that's how you are. Yeah, so that's what I got from Ulta. Billy, look at me. She's totally judging you. Okay, y'all can't see Billy. He
like,
Billy is totally judging you. Yeah, even Billy was just sick.
He's not supposed to be out.
He's not supposed to be out. He is sick. He has had the shits for 3 days now. He's pooped in the house 3 times. The last time he just pooped in the house, it was runny poop on my white rug. So the fact that he's out of his cage, Billy, go get back in your cage. Do you have to go outside? Do you have to go potty for real?
My dang on nerves. Been shitting on that rug, and you just walk around the house like you ain't did nothing. Make it quick, sir. Go.
So anyway, this camera is going dead. It's literally blinking. Now Cairo is about to get started because Bentley went outside and he's still in his cage, so he's feeling some type of way. But I was gonna retwist my locks tonight. That's not gonna happen because it's already midnight and I just got done cleaning the kitchen from cooking dinner. And I need to finish packing. So we gonna pick this vlog up tomorrow. We are done shampooing our locks. Y'all, they are growing so much. They're almost down to my butt. Like, they're right above my butt. So I have to retwist, but while I let these air dry just a little bit, because I hate trying to retwist while they're soaking wet. So, like, especially this part, I wanted this to air dry just a little bit. And then I'll add water up here as needed, because it has to be wet. So while I waited for it to air dry just a little bit, I decided I'm just gonna go ahead and start packing up my makeup and my, you know, my cosmetic stuff. So let's do that. All right, so the camera keeps on wanting to dim for whatever reason. Then when I get closer to it, it brightens up and it won't stay like that. So we just gonna have to do what it do. I got this little bag from Amazon. I'll link it in my Amazon store. But I got this to pack all of my makeup in. I can put the makeup in this part, and then in this part, I can put like my brushes and things of that sort. So let's go ahead and get this packed up. Let's start off with things that's gonna take up the most space. That way I can kind of squeeze everything else around it. So I'm bringing my NARS blush little thing. I don't know what this is called, but it's blush. It's orgasm, NARS orgasm, orgasm foreplay. Yeah, blush, yeah, what that says. So I'm gonna bring this. I have my NARS bronzer, and then should I pack this? I might pack this one too. Just in case. I don't know if I'm gonna use this one or not, but this is Ginger Binge in Moscow Mule. I'm gonna go ahead and still pack my highlighter that Cairo messed up, because I feel like I can squeeze a little bit more out of here. This is called Hustle Baby. You know what? Is this one called Hustle Baby? Yes, this is Hustle Baby. So the one that I just showed y'all in my haul from Ulta is Hustle Baby. I didn't realize that these were the same things. One is liquid and one is powder form. So I'm gonna bring both of them just in case. Let me clean this off a little bit. It's a little nasty. I'm bringing the one that I just bought yesterday called Hustle Baby. I think I wanna bring my concealers. I have the Lancome All Over Concealer in, what shade is this one? I don't know how to read their shades. 415, I think that says 415, but I'm gonna bring this NARS concealer as well. This is the one that I like to wear under my eyes. What color is this one? Custard. Ooh. I'm gonna bring my Fenty. This is my summer color, 370. I have not been wearing foundation lately, but I'm bringing this just in case. And then I'm bringing my Urban Decay All Nighter Face Primer. Y'all, this is so good. Like, it's like, if you need something to help your makeup stick to your face, this shit sticks. And I'm bringing the telescopic by L'Oreal that I showed y'all the other day, well, yesterday, from my Ulta Haul. Bringing that. This is a must have. Like, I cannot leave without this mascara. Then I have the NYX micro brow pencil. Y'all, I have not found a brow pencil better than this. This shit right here, fire. And then I'm also packing the Dolce Gabbana. I don't know why I want to say Cabana all the time. The Dolce Gabbana, I just did it again. The Dolce Gabbana perfume. So let's move on to the brushes. Y'all, my brushes suck. So I'm not going to even go into detail about them because they're not worthy enough to go into detail about. I'm just going to start stuffing them in here. Let me show y'all. Okay, so y'all see how they have these little pouches that you can put your brushes in. Y'all, I'm not even 100% sure that these brushes are even clean. So don't judge me, because I honestly don't know. And then I can put the smaller ones on this side, like so, like that. Let me put these ones in here. These are my Morphe brushes. They're new. I didn't have them for forever, and I haven't used them. So what better time to use them other than vacation? So let's throw those in there. And what else am I missing? I'm gonna throw this one in there. That should be it. I'm gonna put that one in there for shits and giggles. And that should be it. So I'll basically show y'all one last view. There you have the brushes, and then you open it up to the other side, and I have all of my makeup. So that's that. We're gonna close this up. Well, I'll close the top part up first. Then I'll close this bottom part. And there you have it. It's ready to be put into my suitcase. And we're ready to move on to the next thing. And now we're gonna go in with the toiletries. So I got this little cheap bag, y'all, because normally, a lot of times, I leave my toiletries where we're at. Like when it's time to fly home, most of the time, I take this whole bag and I toss it with everything that was in it, because I'm not bringing home travel size stuff. I'm just not. So I put a plastic bag in there because I don't want anything to bust open and to get on any of my stuff in my suitcase. I know there are probably better ways that I can do this, but this is how I'm doing it right now. So I am packing some face wash because I gotta wash my face. And I actually like this, but I normally don't use this on a day-to-day basis. I'm just using this brand because they had the travel size, and I'm not one of those girlies, you know, to get the empty bottles to put stuff in. Yeah, I'm not that girl. I'm just gonna buy a travel size of what I need, and then that shit's getting tossed in before I come home. So we're gonna put that in there. Then I got some mouthwash because, duh, can't be walking around with no stinking breath. Then I have some lotion, so I'm gonna put that in there. Some body wash because I gotta wash my ass. Some deodorant because ain't nobody trying to be musty. Some Tums, which this type of stuff I probably won't leave there. I'll probably bring it back, but I'll just throw it in my purse or something. But I am prone to heartburn, so I'm taking these. Some Tylenol, just in case I get a headache. Tylenol normally does nothing for me, but I'm packing it anyway because ibuprofen has messed my stomach up so bad that I can't take it anymore. So that's that. A small thing of toothpaste, a little, and yes, this is new because it's not in a package. I don't want nobody to be like, she reusing. It's new. I just took it out the package. So that's my toothbrush, some floss. Then I got this on the go tie little thing because just in case I mess up some of my clothes or something. I have some wet ones. Just stuff that down in there. And y'all, my allergies have been going cray cray, so I'm bringing some little things of Benadryl just in case I need those. I'm gonna actually get a different bag. I have this little cheap bag. So I'm gonna put my edge control in there. I have some face wash. I use this when I have makeup on. It helps me remove the makeup. It's by Good Molecules. It's actually pretty good. I'll put that in there. And then I forgot, y'all, my setting spray, my MAC setting spray. It won't fit in my cosmetic bag, so I'm just gonna put it in this bag with that stuff. And then I have my MAC moisturizer for my face. Y'all, I love this stuff. I looked up on this at like TJ Maxx or Marshall's, one of those. I hope I can find more of this when I run out because I actually like it. So I got that. And then I need my Unseen sunscreen. It didn't wipe off a little bit, but it's Unseen sunscreen. This is the best. I use this on my face only. I use regular sunscreen on my body, but that on my face. I feel like I might be missing something in these bags, but I'm just gonna sit the bags out for now. I'm just gonna sit them in on my vanity in my bathroom, and as I pack, if I forget things, the bags are still open. I could just throw them in there before I put them in a suitcase. So that's that. Let's go ahead and move on to the next thing. Now it is time to retwist these dusty locks. I am still shocked that I literally just retwisted these like two and a half weeks ago and they already look crazy like this. So I am trying a new product. The new product that I am trying this time is this stuff. This shit was expensive as hell. It was 20 some dollars on, it don't smell like nothing, on Amazon. I'll link it in my Amazon store as well, just in case y'all wanna try it. But I saw a lot of mixed reviews, mostly good reviews saying that this shit holds like crazy. And then other reviews that said it was too greasy. Only reason why I'm still trying this is because all the other products I have tried was literally greasy. So I'm like, at this point, I have nothing to lose because I'm used to the shit being greasy after I retwist my locks. So I'm trying this, and then I normally start off with moisturizing. So I shampooed my hair. No, I do not condition it because if I continue to put conditioner in this, it's not gonna continue locking up. It's just not. It's gonna take forever. So I do have to restore moisture back into my hair by using this stuff. This is not the normal stuff that I was using, but it's like the next best thing. It was the same brand, but just a different type of oil. It was like a conditioning oil, I wanna say, but I couldn't find it, so we're gonna just settle for this. And then I am using just a spray bottle with some regular water in it to wet the area that I am retwisting at the moment. And of course, I'm gonna start from the back and make my way up to the front, but it's gonna take me a little while, so I'm just gonna prop my phone up, maybe look up something to watch on YouTube or Netflix. Y'all know I'm not a TV person, but when I'm retwisting my locks, I almost have to like keep myself occupied with something, and watching a little TV is probably the best thing. So I'm just pumping this into my hand, like so, like that, and then I'm gonna just move it around my locks. I don't put this at the ends of my locks. I just put this like at my scalp for the most part and around my edges. Because we can't have no dry edges because ain't nobody got time for the edges to be trying to break off and stuff. And then I gotta make sure I get the back. Because y'all know that kitchen be kitchening from time to time. So I do it like that. And then as I go, I'll add like oil in certain sections that I feel that I feel feels a little dry still. But this is just how I start. Okay. So we got that, and let's get this retwist process started. I'm not gonna sit under the dryer because I have other shit to do. So I'm gonna just kind of let it air dry as much as it can. So I'm gonna just walk around the house being a stiff neck. You know how when you get your hair done, you don't wanna move your neck? That's how I'm finna be walking around. And then I need to clean up my bathroom because I made a mess. Y'all, this product though, so far so good. Like, we'll see. I'll give y'all another update on it. But it don't feel greasy like that to me. Not like the other products I've used. In the other products I've used, it made my hands feel really weird after I get done retwisting. This don't. I wash my hands and my hands feel normal. And y'all, look at these edges. Y'all see how good they slick them edges down? So I don't know. We might be onto something, but I'm gonna let y'all know after I get back from Cancun how well my retwist held up. But on another note, let's move on to the next thing. Now I'm just taking a couple of moments to try on some of my last minute outfits. Well, not outfits, because they're not really outfits, they more like dresses. This was one of them. This was one of my favorite ones, but I wasn't sure if I was gonna get a chance to wear it or not. This one I actually got from a friend of mine. She owns a boutique. I will tag her in the description just in case y'all want to get one, because this was really cute. And then this swimsuit, can we get into that cover up though? That cover up was everything. But then I was like, nah, they need to see the whole swimsuit. So I had to come up out of the cover up. Y'all, this swimsuit is so cute and I love the color. This, what is that, an off-white or a tan? Love it. But yeah, this is just me trying on my last minute stuff to make sure everything fits, everything looks right, and we're gonna move on into packing. When I'm packing, I'm not really doing nothing too special, but I do want to pack everything in there fairly neat. I started off with my PJs, and then I'm doing the swimsuit. So I'm putting in the cover up, and then I'm putting whichever swimsuit matches that cover up on top of it to kind of keep them together. And then I'm trying to like squeeze as many like piles in there as I can to kind of get everything in there. Now, I've seen some people have these little cute bags that they put
each outfit in when they travel and then they pack that. I thought about that, but I just be feeling like I be packing too much random stuff to do that. So I'd rather just fold this shit up neatly and just put it in here as neat as I can. Now I am actually putting in some extra outfits, some just in case outfits. You know how you just gotta have like stuff just in case. So that's what I'm doing now. And then I'm gonna put the shoes in. Those shoes that y'all see in that bag are like some old sneakers because we are supposed to go ride. I think they're like ATVs, and I know it's gonna be kind of dirty and muddy, and I didn't want to wear any of my good shoes, and I put it in the bag because they stink. They smell horrible. And then I couldn't decide which pair of heels I wanted to bring, so I just brought all of them. And then of course you got to bring a whole bunch of flip-flops because I'm gonna be wearing flip-flops the majority of the time. And then I had to kind of like rearrange the stuff. Those Telfar bags are in that plastic bag as well because they wouldn't lay down right, so I had to put them in the bag to make sure they lay right. Then I put my cosmetic bag, some sunglasses. I've seen a sunglass case for this, but I didn't get one, so I'm just gonna put them in their case. Then I have my GoPro, my wireless mic, and a ring light. And y'all, we are done packing the suitcase. So moving on along to my carry-on, y'all, I go everywhere with my laptop. Literally, I don't travel nowhere without my laptop because I be working. And then of course I need a passport because I need a passport to get to Cancun. So I had to make sure I had that in there. This is my battery charger for my vlogging camera. And this is like my external memory drive. I think that's what it's called. But I brought that just in case I needed it. And this is like all of the chargers to all of the devices that I'm bringing. I just kind of bought them bitches up and just put them in the pocket because who got time to be organizing them? And then I always travel with a jacket because we all know the airport be hella cold. But it's been some times that the airport was hot, but most of the time the airport is cold. So I'm bringing a jacket just in case I get a little cold. Then I had to kind of rearrange some stuff too because I had forgot. I put my vlogging camera in there, and girl, why would you try to put it in there upside down? Like, why would you put it in a bag like that? But you know, I need money, so I had to bring my wallets. I have two wallets. It's a whole reason why. I'm not gonna go through it right now, just know I need them. So I put everything in there and we gonna bundle her right on up and we moving on to the next thing, y'all. Now I'm about to go into Target to grab what are they called, cover-up bottoms. I think I told y'all about it a couple clips ago, to go with my swimsuit. Oh, that's right. I went to a different Target and they didn't have my size. So now I'm at, my camera is, sorry about that. My bag on lens is dirty. It's still dirty. It's like greasy. But anyway, I went to a different Target and they didn't have any of my size. I do not need a cart. I am not going to get enough stuff in here to where I need a cart. I'm just running in here to see if they got those cover-ups and then I'm back out of here. So it looks like they only have a size large, and I think large might be pushing it. These might be way too big on me. They might be falling off and everything else, but I'm tempted to try these things on. See, these kind of big. I'm tempted to still try them on though. So I found an extra small also, and I know it's gonna be too small, but I'm gonna try them both on just in case one of them just happens to fit, because I need these. I got one other Target I can go to, but I really don't feel like it.
I ended up getting the extra small because I feel like it could have been a little bit bigger, but it didn't look too bad. Plus I had shorts on under it. So once it's like over a swimsuit, it might be a little bit better. But anyway, I end up getting an extra small. And then I got this cute little carrier thing for my jewelry that I'm traveling with. I have no clue how to put it in here. I'm looking at this thing like, how is this stuff supposed to go in here? Because I got necklaces, some bracelets. I got a few rings. I'm not a ring person. I'm not an accessorizer. I don't know if y'all have noticed, but I'm not an accessorizer. I'm trying to do better. So I do have some accessories that I am traveling with. So I got that just so it can be a little easier
for me to pack those things. So I'm leaving Target. I'm tempted to go to this one last Target to see if they have those bottoms in a small. I was looking for a medium, but after I tried on that large, I'm thinking a medium might be too big too. So I'm interested to see if the other Target has a small, but I'm like, do I really feel like driving another 15 minutes? Not really. I still need to pick up dinner because I have to feed the kids. So I think I might just deal with the extra small. Worst case scenario, I'll give them to Lexi when I'm done for next summer or something. I don't know. So yeah, we're moving on to the next thing.
I am finally ready to go. I have some whiteners with it, some whitening strips on my teeth right now. Just in case you guys can notice, don't get in the comments talking about what's wrong with your teeth. They're just whitening strips. So I'm packed. The house is tidy. Of course, it could be better, but I know that my family is still gonna be here while I'm gone. So I'm not gonna like clean because then it's gonna piss me off when I come back home and it's a mess again. But I did tidy it up, so it does look nice. Laundry is done. I did go back to the other Target. Well, not back. I did go to the other Target and I did find those bottoms that I was looking for. I did find them in a small. So my flight leaves at 10 a.m. in the morning, so I have to be at the airport. We're in St. Louis. The airport here is not too bad. So I can literally show up an hour before boarding and I'll be fine. But I do want to get up kind of early because I want to stop off at the bank to get some, not the bank. Yeah, stop off at the bank to get some cash. I got some today while the bank was open. The fund police said that he didn't feel like it was enough. So I'm gonna go to the ATM and pull out some more. And then I wanted to stop at Walmart or something like that to grab some snacks because that's one thing I forgot to pack. Some snacks. And I will go crazy if I don't have snacks while I'm on this vacation. So I'm gonna grab me some snacks and that should be it. I'm a little nervous. My anxiety is on one a little bit because if y'all don't know anything about me, I am not a social person. It may appear to be that I am social because of social media. I'm social with myself. When I'm doing these videos, I'm literally talking to myself. I'm talking to the camera, so I'm talking to myself. I'm fine, like, once I get in a situation and I get comfortable, I am fine. But before getting into the situation, it makes me a little anxious. So me knowing that I'm about to be around 10 people that I don't even know in one house together for 4 days, it's stressing me out just a little bit. But I know I'm gonna be fine. I know that I'm gonna have some fun. But anyway, make sure y'all check back for the vacation vlog. Let me know in the comments if I should break it up day by day. Should I do like a one vlog per day, or should I just kind of bundle it up into one vlog? Because I haven't made my mind up yet, because I'm not exactly sure how much footage I will be getting, but I feel like I'm gonna be getting a lot of footage. So I don't know, let me know in the comments y'all thoughts. Do y'all just wanna see it all at once, or do y'all want me to, like, you know, throw it out there one at a time? Just let me know, but make sure you check back for that vlog. And as always, until next time.